I am Rajesh Sahani from India. I run an accelerator program, India's first multi-city accelerator program, GSF Super GSF Accelerator. I'm also the founder of GSF Super Angels, a leading angel club in India. It's been fantastic. You know, the energy and networking possibilities. You're meeting such incredibly smart people from across the world, especially from Eastern Europe. It's my first time here and I'm super impressed. I like the people, I like the energy, I like the way it's being conducted. I like the panels, a few that I've seen yesterday. I'm looking forward to the India panel discussion there. I've liked the opportunity to meet with people over dinner yesterday. It's been amazing. So I think the exits are speeding up in India. There are two in India, exits historically have been difficult for tech companies, because to build a company to do an IPO, it takes about 10 years in India. But I think the momentum is coming with the companies like Naukri, MakeMyTrip, and MakeMyTrip doing an exit on NASDAQ. We have a large number of companies now primed this year and next year to do IPOs. What the other thing that is sort of building up and which impresses me is the mid-market M&A. And there are two kind of possibilities there. One, the foreign companies coming and buying into Indian companies to get started. But also equally impressive is some of the Indian companies, especially venture-backed Indian companies, becoming acquisitive. I think the acquisition momentum will pick up in years to come. I guess most of the well-known foreign VCs operate in India, and many of them have even dedicated India funds like Sequoia has, but most of them are there. And the VC ecosystem is very robust in India. We have a large number of VC firms willing to provide capital, but historically they have mostly focused on Series A, Series B kind of investments and investment in ignorance. And that's the place where GSF Accelerator is focused on, and GSF Super Angels are focused on. Two, three things, I think, when you think of building business. One is, no matter how well you plan, you change, because your customers have different expectation of your product than you think when you plan. So you must listen to the market. And most of the companies I've been involved at early stage had to pivot, not only once, but many times, before they really hit their sweet spot. So I think listening to your customers is very important, and changing with the flow is very important for the entrepreneurs. Secondly, Indian market is very large, but it's also very diverse. In the sense, there are a lot of dynamic at play between different regions. So it's also a very fragmented market. So from outside it may look young. So it's basically like European market, which is fragmented. So if you learn to deal with those regional variations, with language barriers, that's what sort of, I think, Indian entrepreneurs can share their experiences with Ukrainians. So in India, I think where capital is lacking is in angel and seed stage. There's a lot of capital, Series A, Series B and C, which is unlike many other markets, where typically I think in Europe, it's easier to get started. The angel money is easily available. But where European startup struggle is to raise later. In India, we have exactly the opposite situation. I think taking the company's scale is tough, both in Europe and India. And that, I think, is something common. I think in India, this problem will be addressed. India adopts internet in a very, very big way. We have about 1 billion people using mobile phone now, and 100 million people on internet. I think in next 10 years, 1 billion new people will come and use internet in India, mostly through mobile internet, and that will create huge possibility of building large-scale companies very fast. So I'm very excited about it. I think mobile internet is going to change the world. It will have a huge impact on the way we think of internet and the way we think of technology in coming time, and we'll start seeing its impact very, very soon.